हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर अनिल कुमार फ्रॉम सेंटर फॉर मेडिकल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, एमडी यूनिवर्सिटी रोहतक। आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन मॉड्यूल ऑर्गन कल्चर एंड एप्लीकेशंस अंडर पेपर एनिमल सेल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव, आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल द स्टूडेंट शुड बी एबल टू लर्न अबाउट बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ टिश्यू कल्चर, different organ culture techniques and the application of organ culture in the various field of medical. Introduction. So first of all, you must know what is a tissue culture. As you know, culture, we are basically growing the cells. So tissue culture is a general term used for the removal of the cell, tissue, organ from an animal or plant, and their subsequent placement into artificial environment which will be conducive to growth. Now when we are saying artificial environment, basically we are placing the cells, we are growing the cell in vitro, we are giving their artificial environment by giving their pH, by providing certain supplements, a growth hormone externally. Now organ culture refers to the in vitro growth, an explantation of organ, part of organ, in a way that allows differentiation and preservation of architecture so that explanted tissue closely resemble the parent tissue in vivo. The whole organ or part of organ is maintained usually by culturing the tissue at the liquid gas interface on a grid or gel. History of tissue culture. In 1885, Rox maintained embryonic stick cell in a saline culture. In 1897, Loeb demonstrated the survival of the cells isolated from blood and connective tissue in a serum and plasma. In 1907, Harrison cultivated frog nerve cell in a lymph clot held by the hanging drop method. In 1911, Lewis and Lewis made the first liquid media consisted of sea water, serum, embryo extract, salt, and peptones. In 1913, Carroll introduced strict aseptic techniques so that cells could be cultured for longer period. In 1916, Rouse and Jones introduced proteolytic enzyme trypsin for the subculturing of adherent cells. In 1933, Gay developed the roller tube technique for the culturing of cells. In 1940s, the use of antibiotics such as penicillin and streptomycin in the culture medium decreased the problem of contamination in cell culture. In 1961, Hayflick and Moorhead isolated human fibroblast WI38 and showed that they have finite lifespan in culture. In 1965, Ham introduced first serum-free medium which was able to spot the growth of some cells. In 1982, human insulin became the first recombinant protein to be licensed as a therapeutic agent. In 1985, human growth hormone produced from recombinant bacteria was accepted for therapeutic use. Now, equipment and facility which is required for the tissue culture or organ culture. You have a requirement of sterile working area, so you can use laminar airflow for that. Incubation facility include incubators such as CO2 incubator you can use to maintain pH and temperature. Refrigerator, freezer, minus 20 and minus 80 are needed. Microscopes such as inverted microscope are needed to check the growth pattern of the cells. Tissue culture vials such as plastic ware and culture vessel are required for proper growth of the cells, and filter are needed for sterilization. You can use syringe filter and the membrane filter. So what are the characteristics of organ culture? What we should consider, what we should not consider? The first characteristic: there should be a nutrient and gases exchange. Why it is necessary? Because due to the absence of vascular system exchange of gases does not occur properly between tissue and media. So it can lead to necrosis in central cell in organ culture with tissue. Therefore, proper exchange of gases should be there while we are dealing with the organ culture. The second most important thing is a structure integrity. To avoid breakage in tissue, proper care should be taken to maintain its structure and histology. The cell should not detach during the process, as we doing the many procedure, invasive procedure to the organ culture. So that can lead to the deterioration of cell's integrity. The third one is the growth and differentiation. The cells which have already obtained their differential stage, so they don't proliferate, they do not grow in cell culture, but sometimes outgrowth is observed. So growth and differentiation is an important characteristic of organ culture. Condition for organ culture. The first thing which is a prior requirement, that is a media or medium. Media used in organ culture is similar to that of cell culture. We can use TCM 199 or CMR 1066 with or without serum. The another condition which is a spot type. It can be spotted by a filter made of polycarbonate lying on either grid or filter level insert. The oxygen tension is also a primary requirement for organ culture. The elevated oxygen concentration is required to maintain cell in a proper growth. The gaseous exchange is also a primary condition for organ culture. It can be maintained by using stirred, rocking and rotated type of culture. Now, what is the procedure for organ culture? First, you have to collect the organ and tissue and dissect it, then reduce the size of tissue as per your desire, and preferably it is less than 1 millimeter in thickness. Place the tissue on a spot at a gas medium interface spot, then incubate in a humid CO2 incubator. Change the medium. You can use both of the medium, like M199 or CMR L1066. You can use one of the medium as frequently as desired. Now, after the culturing, organ culture can be analyzed by histology, autoradiography and the immunochemistry. In this slide, we are going to discuss about what are the techniques for organ culture. There are the various technique. First technique is the plasma clot or Watchglass method. Second one is the raft method. It can be done using agar gel, grid method, cyclic exposure to medium and gas phase. Now, first coming to the plasma clot or Watchglass method, it is used to study the development of avian limb bone rudiment, but was extended to investigate growth and differentiation of other avian and mammalian tissues. By this method, avian tissue are placed on a clot consisting of a chick plasma and chick embryo extract in equal proportion, which is contained in a watch glass. Normally, one or two such watch glasses are enclosed in a petri dish carpeted with the moist cotton wool or filter paper to prevent evaporation of the clot and explant. As in this figure, you can see that there is a petri dish is there, and in petri dish there is a explant which has been spotted on the plasma clot. Then this plasma clot has been kept on a watch glass, and it has been sealed from the top by paraffin wax, or you can use a filter paper for this one. Advantage of plasma method: it is less expensive, it permits light microscope, hence suitable to study the hair growth, fetal mouse skin differentiation. But the disadvantage: first one is the clot liquefies in vicinity of explant, so explant can become immersed in medium. Second one, short duration of culture, it will require less than 4 week. Biochemical analysis is not possible due to the complexity of medium. Now, where this technique can be used? GLAS method. The application include, it can be used to study the morphogenesis in embryonic organ rudiments. It can be used to study the action of hormones, vitamins, carcinogen on adult mammalian tissues. Now coming to the next method for organ culture, that is the raft method. This is the method in which explants are placed on a raft which is made up of prion acetate, which is then floated on a serum, particularly in a watch glass. There can be four or more explant can be placed on a single raft. The floatability of lens, paper or prion acetate, which is a raft, can be enhanced by it treating with its silicone. The combination method. In this method, explants are first placed on the raft of a glass and the stable material then placed on the plasma cloud. So we are using both raft and plasma cloud in this case. That's why we are calling it as a combination method. This prevents the sinking of explant into liquefied plasma, as you can see in the figure. The next method for organ culture is the agar gel method. Because when we are using the watch glass method, the problem encountered using plasma cloth could be eliminated by using agar gel. The agar method has been successfully used for the development and the morphogenetic studies. In this case, medium is gel with the 1% agar and gel are then kept in embryological watch glass. The explant is then transferred on surface of agar sealed with the paraffin wax. After the sealing, subculturing is done into fresh agar gel every 5 to 7 days. Explant can be examined with stereoscopic microscope for histology and immunochemistry purpose. The technique is mainly used to study the many developmental aspect of normal organ as well as tumor. As you can see in this picture, there is a petri dish in which a vas glass has been placed. And in on a vas glass, there is an explant is placed on a plasma cloud, on a agar gel, sorry. The next method, we are having grid method. Because use of a raft floating on a fluid medium sometime did not provide an ideal condition. The raft, as we know, they can sink and the tissue become frequently. And to differentiate depth immersed into the medium, the difficulty can be overcome by the grid technique, which was given by the Trowell. When we are using skeletal tissue, they can be kept directly on the grid. So when we are dealing with the softened tissues, they are firstly kept on the raft, then they are transferred to the grid. The grid is kept in a culture chamber filled with the fluid medium up to grid. So the chamber which is containing fluid, which is then it is flushed with the oxygen and CO2 to maintain the requirement of oxygen concentration and to maintain the pH of that particular fluid. This particular technique, it can be used to study the growth and differentiation of adult and embryonic tissue. As in this particular figure, you can look for the, there is a explant has been placed on a raft that has basically placed on the liquid media, which further was carried out in a petri dish. This is the method which is less commonly used. This method known as the cyclic exposure to medium and gas phase. This method is useful for long term when we are desired to culture the things for 4 to 5 months. It is a most stable for culture of human adult tissues. 2 to 8 explant per dishes are attached at the bottom of plastic culture dish and covered with the fluid medium. Dishes are enclosed in a chamber containing suitable gas mixture mounted on rocker platform for cyclic exposure of medium and gas. What are advantage and disadvantage in application of this technique? Advantage include explant remain comparable, so it is a suitable to study the physiological studies. It may replace whole animal in experimentation. As a result from them, they are easy to interpret. A disadvantage, it is a very costly technique. Now where this technique can be used, it can be used to study the pattern of growth, differentiation, development of organ rudiment. It can be used to study the action of drug and carcinogen on organ. It can also can be used for development of tissue called the tissue engineering for implantation in patient, for generation of artificial tissue like artificial cartilage, artificial skin. Application of organ culture. So till now we have discussed about what are the different techniques we can use for the organ culture. So organ culture has certain importance in biodiversity area. So coming to the application of organ culture, it can be used to maintain structural organization of tissue from experimentally varied environments such as hormones, drug and radiation. It can be used to study morphogenesis, differentiation and the function in excised organ or presumptive organs. It can also be used for comparison of growth and behavior of explanted organ with the growth and behavior of similar organ in situ. The environmental variable can be studied by means of organ culture. Different environmental variables like radiation, vitamins, mainly vitamin A and carcinogen, they can be studied. It clearly explains and distinguishes the effect of several hormone on particular structure. There are the number of examples are there where the organ culture has been the most promising technique. For example, mammary gland are most commonly used to investigate responses of several hormones and its secretory activities. It can also be used to for as a vehicle for a mammary tumor agent. The toxic effect of steroid hormones on mammary and adenocarcinomas of C3H mice in organ culture have been examined. The cultivation of mouse ova has made possible the production in vitro of genotypically mosaic embryos from fused eggs. It has also contributed to our understanding of embryonic induction and of the control of morphogenesis by juxtaposition of specific cell types. The effect of specific mesenchymal element upon epithelial structure has been also elucidated. The study of organ culture also helps in the pigment formation in a hair follicles melanocyte of agouti mice by organ culture, which has contributed towards the growth of hair and hair follicles. By means of organ culture, development anomalies in heart disease and defect can also be studied. For example, growth of normal retinas of CBA and BALB-C mice in the analysis of change of occurring in inherited retinal dystrophy in C3H animals. Second example include examination of potential of kidney rudiment of prospective kidneyless mice. As we have discussed various application of organ culture, it has also certain limitation. Now, what are the limitation and shortcoming of organ culture? There is a very slow growth associated with different cell and cell types, vary from cell to cell types. It is difficult to maintain and very expensive technique. It requires so much of artificial media and of artificial environment. We have to maintain the things. It can be maintained only for a few months. The variation are high, but with low reproducibility. The fresh explantation is required for every experiment that make technique much more expensive. For each experiment, a new or fresh organ is needed as organ culture are not propagated. Current progress. Now, what is currently going in this organ cell culture technique? In April 2006, scientists reported a successful trial of 7 bladder grown in vitro and given to human. A bladder has been cultured by Anthony et al. Of Wake Forest Institute of Regenerative Medicine in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. A jawbone has been cultured at Columbia University. A lung has been cultured at Yale. A beating heart has been cultured by Doris Taylor at the University of Minnesota. An artificial kidney has been cultured by Henry David Humes at the University of Michigan. The silk cut from silkworm cocoons has been successfully used as growth scaffolding for heart tissue production. Heart tissue does not regenerate if damaged, so producing replacement patches is of great interest. The experiment used rat heart cells and produced functional heart tissue. So in order to further test application to humans as a cure, a way to transform human stem cell into heart tissue would have to be found. In 2016, another test was done in which human cells were used to assemble intricately structured heart. The hearts ultimately proved immature, but proved we were yet one step further to making a heart from stem cell. The attempt was further made in January 2017. Scientists from Salk Institute for Biological Studies managed to create a pig embryo that had a part of its DNA critical for the growth of organs edited out. They then introduced human stem cells inside the pig embryo to have the human DNA, which was used to fill the gap. So student, let us summarize what we actually have discussed in particular topic, organ culture and application. The organ culture, as we have discussed, as we have defined the things, it refers to the in vitro growth and explantation of organ or part of organ in a way that allows the differentiation preservation of architecture so that explanted tissue closely resemble its parent tissue in vivo. The organ culture should possess certain characteristics like, so there should be a proper gaseous exchange, there should be a proper growth and differentiation, and it should maintain the structural integrity. There are the various techniques have been defined to do the organ culture. The techniques like Raft method we have discussed, watch glass method we have discussed, agar gel method can be used for in vitro organ culture. Each of the method have certain advantage and disadvantage, and each of the method can be applied for the different type of studies. Then we have discussed organ culture. It can be used to study the morphogenesis, differentiation and the function in excised organ or presumptive organ. This technique can be used to compare the growth and behavior of explanted organ with the growth and behavior of similar organ which has been grown in vivo condition. Although this technique has many application like other technique, yet it suffers from certain limitation, like sometimes it is a very difficult to maintain the growth of a culture because of a very slow growth, or when we are doing the experiment, every time there is a fresh explantation is required for every experiment. Thank you.